Hello, B here, and welcome back to Integrated Physics and Chemistry. Have you or your family member ever had a stomach ache and taken an antacid to help settle your stomach? An antacid is a medicine made of a weak base that helps to neutralize the acids in your stomach to help you feel better. In this lesson, we will be learning about neutralization reactions between acids and bases. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define a neutralization reaction, define pH, and identify the pH ranges for acids and bases. Discuss how indicators can be used to determine if a solution is an acid or a base. I want you to look at these two double displacement reactions. What do you notice? They both have one reactant, that is an acid, and one reactant, that is a base, and they both produce water. These two reactions are a specific type of double displacement reaction called a neutralization reaction. A neutralization reaction occurs when an acid and a base in an aqueous solution react to form water and a salt. When you hear the word salt, you probably think of table salt or the salt you put on ice on the road in the winter. But the chemical definition of a salt is an ionic compound formed from the positive ion from a base and the negative ion from an acid. If you look back at the neutralization reaction we looked at a few minutes ago, the Na plus 1 from the base forms an ionic compound with the Cl minus 1 from the acid to form sodium chloride, or NaCl, which is table salt. Let's pretend I have a beaker of NaOH and I add a single drop of HCl. Is this solution now neutral? Well, all of the H plus ions from the hydrochloric acid, or HCl, reacted with OH minus ions from the sodium hydroxide. But because I only added one drop of HCl, there will be some OH minus ions from the sodium hydroxide base left over. This is because there aren't enough H plus ions to make water with every OH minus ion. This means that because there are more OH minus ions in the solution than H plus ions, the solution remains basic. A neutralization reaction only forms a neutral salt and water when there is an equal number of OH minus ions and H plus ions in the solution. This is one place where balancing equations is important. Ever look at your deodorant and see the term pH balanced? Your body has a natural pH, which stands for potential of hydrogen, or how much hydrogen is in the solution. pH is a measure of how acidic or basic a solution is. When a deodorant is pH balanced, that means it works to help balance the natural pH of your skin to help with odor and perspiration. The pH scale is a range of numbers from 0 to 14 that indicate how acidic or basic a solution is. If the pH value is less than 7, the solution is acidic, and if it is greater than 7, the solution is basic. If the pH is equal to 7, then the solution is considered neutral. pH values do not have units, and the farther from 7 a pH value is, the more acidic or basic the solution is. For example, if I have two acids, one with a pH of 2 and one with a pH of 5, the solution with a pH of 2 is considered more acidic, meaning it has more H+ ions in the solution. If I have two basic solutions, one with a pH of 9 and one with a pH of 12, which do you think would be more basic and why? The solution with a pH of 12 would be more basic because it would have more OH- ions in the solution. How can we determine the pH of a solution, or even whether a solution is an acid or a base? We can use indicators. There are many different types of chemical indicators. Two common ones are litmus paper and the liquid indicator, Bromothymol blue. Litmus paper is a chemical paper that can be dipped in a solution. When dipped in a solution, it changes color based on whether the solution is an acid or base. The more blue the paper becomes, the higher the pH or more basic the solution is. And the more red the paper turns, the lower the pH or more acidic the solution is. Bromothymol blue is a liquid indicator. Liquid indicators work by adding a few drops to the solution and reading the color change. Each liquid indicator works with a different color change and different ranges of pH. But for bromothymol blue, if you add a few drops to a basic solution, the solution turns blue. However, if you add a few drops of bromothymol blue indicator to an acidic solution, the solution turns yellow. In our next lesson, you will learn more about indicators by making an indicator using cabbage juice. As we went through the lesson today, we learned how acids and bases come together to form neutral solutions, and how we can use indicators to determine the pH of a solution. Until next time, remember, the universe is vast and full of surprises, so never stop exploring. I'll see you next time. Hey, hey.